So good morning students, in today's lecture we will cover a third method of controlling the voltage in inverters, which is a one type of internal voltage control technique. In my previous lectures I will cover single PWM as well as multiple PWM techniques, but several disadvantages are there in the single and multiple PWM techniques, so that we will now rectify these problems and by using this sinusoidal pulse width modulation technique. So it is also known as a SPWM technique. Instead of maintaining the width of all the pulses same as in case of multiple PWM, the width of each pulse is varied in proportion to the amplitude of the sine wave. So in multiple PWM technique, we will make the width of all the pulses same as 2d by n, but in this technique the width of each pulse is varied in proportion to the amplitude of a sine wave. So by changing the amplitude of the sine wave, which is actually a reference wave in this case, in multiple PWM technique we will take a rectangular pulse as a reference wave, but in case of the sinusoidal PWM technique we will take sine wave as a reference wave. So this is the general block diagram in which a comparator is there, and we will apply high frequency triangular carrier wave, which is a reference which is actually a carrier wave, high frequency carrier wave, and with a sinusoidal reference wave having amplitude of AR is compared in the comparator, and which gives the output which is applied to a trigger pulse generator, and this trigger pulse generator generates the trigger pulses to the SCRs of a single phase full bridge inverter. So in this sinusoidal PWM technique we will take two case studies. First one is the peak of the carrier coincides with the zero of the reference. So what does it means, peak of the carrier? So it is a peak value because it starts from here, and this is the having amplitude of AC, and peak of the carrier coincides with the zero of the reference. So reference waveform is actually a sinusoidal one, and it is passing through a zero. So zero of the reference wave coincides with the peak of the carrier wave because both are the starting points here, and so peak of the carrier is there and zero of the reference is at origin. So in this way peak of the carrier coincides with the zero of the reference. So we will mark the carrier waveform as a triangular one having switching frequency FC and amplitude of AC, or we can take it as VC, and this reference wave having amplitude of AR or VR or simply a frequency of FR will be there. So these are the switching pulses IG1 and IG2 for the thyristor switches T1 T2, and how it generates simply by comparing these carrier and reference waves. So if we compare here this first intersection point of these two waveforms, then we will see that in this case VR is greater than of VC because VC is bottom and VR is higher side. So VR is greater than VC, then in this case switching pulses for the IG1 and IG2 are generated, and in the negative just opposite case is there, VR less than VC, then switching pulses for the IG3 and IG4 are generated. So opposite logic will be there for the IG1 IG2 and IG3 and IG4. And now what is the output voltage waveform? So whenever the switching pulses are applied to the switches, then according to which output voltage is generated. So in positive half cycle switching pulses are in the opposite half, so the output voltage which will be obtained by the conduction of the thyristor switches, so output voltage will be in positive half cycle only having amplitude of VC because two thyristors are conducting at a time. So full DC bus voltage is obtained at the output side in full bridge inverter, and this is the pulse width, and in which we can see that the pulse having not equal width, the pulses generated are equal in width. So in multiple PWM we take all the pulse width to be or generated pulse width having equal amplitude but equal width, but in case of SPWM technique the pulses generated which are having unequal pulse width. And in the negative half cycle you can see the pulses are generated having amplitude of minus VS, and there will be four pulses are there. By the comparison of there, four pulses are generated. So in this case one, The number of pulses generated in each half cycle is given by the formula n equals to fc upon 2fr. So these are the number of pulses generated in case of peak of the carrier coincide with the zero of the reference. So four pulses are generated here. In above case shows four pulses when triangular carrier wave coincide with the sinusoidal reference wave. So four pulses are there, fc upon 2fr. And now in the second case, zero of the carrier coincide with the zero of the reference. So this is a zero of the carrier and zero of the reference, both are at the same point at origin, and they will start from here. And these are the waveforms like this. One is a triangular and one second one is the sinusoidal in nature. So by comparison, we will again see that this is a comparison point, they are there. So again, logic apply, VR greater than VC, then switching pulses are generated for IG1, IG2, and for VR less than VC in the negative cycle, switching pulses for the T3 and T4 are generated. So these are the pulses generated by comparison of the switches, comparison of two waveforms, or three pulses are generated. So number of pulses generated are minus one, because number of pulses generated in first case are fc upon 2fr, but here we see that three pulses are generated, so minus one will be there, because in earlier case four pulses are there. But in case second, because zero of both the waveforms are coincide at the same point, so one pulse is lesser, so minus one will be subtracted there in the formula. So fc upon 2fr minus one are the number of pulses generated in each half cycle. So when zeros of the two waveforms are coincide, n minus 1, that is 3 pulses per half cycle is obtained. What is the output RMS voltage, which is same as in previous case, V0R is equals to Vs in the half cycle of pi, pulse width having 2D and whole raised to the power 1 by 2 for RMS calculation. And here, AR upon AC is the modulation index, or VR upon VC, you can say that amplitude of the reference and carrier wave. So it will be a modulation index, which will be defined by AR upon AC. So by varying the modulation index, RMS output voltage is controlled, and also the harmonic content in the output voltage waveform will be controlled. So now we will see how the harmonic content are controlled by this modulation index. So if the modulation index is having value less than 1, then the dominant harmonics in the output voltage waveform are given by fc upon fr plus minus 1. So these are the number of dominant harmonics which are generated in case of this modulation index is less than of 1. When this modulation index is less than 1, as ac will be greater than of ar. If ac will be higher than ar, then this modulation index will be always less than 1. So number of dominant harmonics are generated by fc upon fr plus minus 1, and which, or we can write that 2n plus minus 1, because n equals to fc upon 2fr, so simply 2 will be in the multiply with n, then it will be 2n plus minus of 1. So put n equals to 3. So what is the order of dominant harmonics? If you put 3 there, then 2 into multiply by 3 plus minus 1, so it will be 5 and 7. And for n equals to if you put n equals to 9, then dominant harmonics having order of 17 and 19. So some of them are the lower order harmonics and some of them are higher order harmonics. So if the domination is shown by the lower order harmonic, that is 5th and 7th, then it is difficult to filter out them, because in waveform always the lower order harmonics are difficult to filter out, but in case of higher order harmonics, which can be easily filtered out by using the filters or by making these component passive components. So but lower harmonics are not easier to filter out. So what we do in the SPWM technique, we will always want n to be higher side. Why n to be higher side? Because as the number of switching pulses in the per half cycle, if we increase, then the order of dominant harmonics are increased. So if the order of dominant harmonics are increased, then the harmonics in the waveform, which we can easily filter out, because higher order harmonics can easily be filtered out. So number of pulses are always, we want that it to be on the higher side. Therefore, in SPWM technique, we will increase the number of pulses in each half cycle and increase the order of the dominant harmonics so that they can easily filtered out. So this is the first case when modulation index is less than 1. Second case is the modulation index is greater than 1. So when it is greater than 1, if AC should be less than, because modulation index equals to AR upon AC. So if AC will be less, then AR will, which is then modulation index will be on greater than always 1. So in this case, lower order harmonics appears, and pulse width is no longer a sinusoidal function of the angular position of the pulse. So if we take modulation index on to be higher side, then we will not obtain the sinusoidal function of the of this pulse, because in this first case, when modulation index is less than 1, we will generally obtain the sinusoidal function. Why? Dekho, this is the pulse which is embedded in this out, this between this output voltage waveform. So this is the pulse which will be there in the half cycle, and it will be there in the 2π. So sinusoidal function of will be there in this case of output voltage waveform, but if you take modulation index to be higher side, then it will not possible to obtain the sinusoidal function. So we will not refer MI greater than 1, we always make it less than 1. So this is the basic of this sinusoidal pulse width modulation technique. In our upcoming lectures, we will cover two types of SPWM technique, that is unipolar and bipolar sinusoidal technique, by which we can see that how the output voltage having bipolar polarities or unipolar polarities. But in this case, our case, only output voltage having only single polarity, because in positive half cycle only positive polarity of the voltage is there, and the negative half cycle minus VL will be there. So there is a single polarity will be there. But in case of unipolar bipolar types of SPWM technique, we will see how in output voltage both types of polarities are will be there. So further we will improve the harmonic performance. So we will continue this lecture. Thank you.